has an opportunity right here to take home a world title and become the next American superstar in all of sports, Mitch Chilson.
Yeah, let's see how he enters into this takedown. Like Chris said, ooh, nice little sweep right there from Uali as they start immediately hand fighting and looking for their grips.
Yeah, you can see Uali's frame and strength right away on this.
Yeah, we got to clinch up in the back and play around a little bit. I thought he was going to toss me through the wall. Nice little back take there by Kade Ruotolo.
He's got the back, Ruotolo does. 1 10-minute round here.
And this was off of an attempted throw by Uali.
Yeah, Uali's trying to fight one hook. Kade still got the back. Nice little drag to the mat right there from Kade Ruotolo. He sneaks one hook in. Let's see if he can get the other one. Uali's going to try to turn into him. Might end up in mount here. Good adjustment from Kade to maintain back position.
Whoever gets the submission wins the fight. Yeah, if it goes the full 10 minutes, it's whoever had the most legitimate attempts, so neither fighter wasting any kind of time here.
Yeah, Kade started to attack there, looking for a Sulayev stretch, but he's gonna try to flatten him out here, possibly go hunting for a neck. Uali's got the right hand of Kade, and Kade's trying to free that arm, but Uali's got good grips. He might be able to pop that right hand out, though. There he does.
He's got to be careful that he doesn't get too far sideways here, allowing Uali to. But he's corrected himself and got back to the top again.
This is what we saw from Kade in his debut against Shinya. He has really good back control as he applies hip pressure to flatten out Uali.
What's Kade setting up here? What's he trying to get?
Now he's got both hands free. Now he's looking to go underneath the neck. Yep. He cross-faced right there. He's applying the rear naked choke. But Uali's got good defense from this position. He can fight those hands. Kade has expressed that he does have MMA ambitions. He wants to transition and go for multiple sports. But right now, he's looking really strong with his back position.
We also got the buggy from the back.
You can hear his brother Ty calling out. He's got the buggy choke from the back. Yep.
Twin brother Ty is a sensation in his own right. Uali Kurzhev also has a twin brother who's at the highest of these levels.
He's got an arm triangle here. Looks like he's going for his signature Darce choke finish. Let's see if Uali can peel this hand off the head. Uali's tough. He's going
to
fight that hand.
Lock it in here.
This is where Kade's 76-inch reach comes in advantage right there, being able to work. And these Darce chokes, anaconda chokes, rear naked chokes.
And Kade's got a similar reach to like Michael Phelps. Those arms are just so long.
5-inch advantage.
Rear naked choke's under. He's right above us. Let's see if he can wrap things up here.
It's not under the chin yet.
On him like a backpack here, just 3 minutes in. Uali Kurzhev gets taken down by Kade. Kade on his back.
Nice little slam right there to end up on top position, but Kade threatens the triangle, goes omoplata, and Uali chooses to run away.
Nice escape there by Uali Kurzhev as he brings the fans into play.
That was good, but those are some submission attempts. I wonder if they're going to count for catches.
What I like about the fact that when Kade hit the ground, as he was going down, he was already looking for a submission, and as Uali was backing away, he was still looking for things to grab, something to clip onto to earn that takedown, or at least just get him out of position like he did with Shinya when he did that low ankle pick.
Good snap downs early by Kade, just trying to disrupt the balance here and the posture of Uali Kurzhev. He pummels inside, Kurzhev chooses to disengage. Jumps guard. Uali's doing a good job of fighting the head position of Kade, but Kade's able to snatch up a single, goes to the body lock, ducks underneath, takes the back up. Uali's trying to roll through.
Looking for a leg there.
Good action from both men in the opening half of this 10-minute fight, one round.
Up, Kade's going for a leg.
See, Kade's passing the guard there, but he's already positioned the leg for the heel hook.
And there he is on it. Heel hook. Uali's doing a good job of fighting the hands. First thing he has to do is fight those hands, but he got extended.
He got it. As he taps.
Wow.
It's over.
Beautiful.
Heel hook. Kade Ruotolo gets it done.
And that was completely set up from the guard pass. Kade was already looking for that from the guard pass. You saw it.
He was in complete control of that fight. Just kept trying different things, showing all of his techniques, and it ends here with a submission victory for the 19-year-old American.
Wow, 19 years old, and he's got two world titles in just over a month, Brett. The future is now.
It was just clinical, and you heard his corner saying it. Just an absolute technician, Kade Ruotolo.
This is that new generation that we're talking about. You know, most BJJ practitioners would be looking to pass that guard of Uali, but while he was setting up the pass on Uali, the whole time he was just feeding that right leg through, looking for that heel. The pass was just a setup for the heel hook.
ADCC championship a month ago, and now he comes back. Kade Ruotolo as advertised. Here's Tom Lowne.
This match was presented to you by Toomey. And now to present the belt for this match, we have the chairman and CEO of One Championship, Mr. Chatri Sityotong. Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Vitor Ribeiro, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 26 seconds for your winner by way of heel hook. And now, undisputed, one lightweight submission grappling champion of the world, Kade Ruotolo!